Hi, this is Lisa Crosbie, fresh from the Microsoft Business Application Summit on 4th of May. May the 4th be with you. Here are my top five exciting things that were announced, summarised for you in 5 minutes, plus an extra bonus one at the end, so do stick around. I'm going to start right from the top here because this is such a big deal that I can't make you wait till the end. Number one is PowerApps Modern App Designer. Now, there's a couple of things going on here. The most exciting thing is that we will now be able to create Canvas custom pages inside model-driven apps. Now, this means if you're using Dynamics 365 or you're creating your own model-driven app, you can now create an interface that looks like this, custom user experience, custom user interface, no code, using the Canvas style designer. This is absolutely game-changing. Also part of the new modern app designer is going to be a much easier way where we're creating forms and views over data. You start by selecting a table and it will just automatically populate those views and forms for you, and then you can move things around and edit them, as opposed to the current experience of pretty much having to drag and drop from scratch when you create custom tables. So that is going to be a massive time saver as well. So heaps of awesome stuff coming up there, especially that custom page feature. Number two then is a follow-on from that, which is that the roadmap has been announced for where this is going. So we're seeing the feature that I just talked about, the modern app designer, coming through in preview in May, pretty much soon. And then what we've got is a roadmap now of saying by about October this year, we're going to see the Canvas apps authoring experience in Teams and the standalone one merge to become just one Canvas apps experience, which will be much more streamlined and easier for people who switch back and forth and use those things. And a year from now, we're going to see a completely converged app experience. You won't have to start with Canvas app or model-driven app. You'll just go create a power app and you'll have this hybrid experience of being able to build Canvas, model-driven, PCF components all in one. This is still kind of visionary, but watch this space. There's going to be a heap more coming there. At number three, and this is probably one of the number one announcements for many other people, but I picked the other one quite shamelessly there, Power BI Goals. This is a major new announcement on the Power BI side. This is effectively a tool that is driven by data sitting in Power BI. So it's using all those native connectors that you're already using in Power BI, where your data, logic, analytics already are, that allows you to connect up your goals. And this is natively built into Teams. It's AI powered, so you can understand how you're going against your goals, find opportunities for improvement and performance, and it's natively connected to Power BI, which means you can trigger off automated processes based on the status of the goals. So there's going to be a lot of press about this one, and that's a super exciting feature there as well. There's a close-up of what the screen will look like. At number four, Power Apps in Teams. Lots of Power Apps stuff is the big announcements out of MBAS this year. Organization-wide apps, what this will mean is you can create an app in Teams if you're using Power Apps in Teams and share to the whole organization. So people don't have to be in the team where you're building the app in order to be able to use it. This is a sounds simple but massive kind of bonus for what we can do here. This is a big barrier to entry for many people. They want to build something, share it across the organization. You are now going to be able to do that. And last but certainly not least, some more out-of-the-box apps inside Teams. So if you're not familiar with these already, we have five to start with. Milestones, bulletins, issue reporting, employee ideas, and inspections. The idea here is these are quick to deploy and you can customize them if you want to as well. We're getting five new ones. Three of them have been announced at MBAS this week and the other two are coming in June. So the first one is Profile Plus, which is apparently like the most in-demand app that's ever been asked for, that will overlay your Azure AD data for your users and bring all of that information about their skills and contact details and all of those things into that app in Teams. I can totally see why everyone would want this one. And then we've got two others coming here, one called Boards and one called Discussions, which are very much about kind of collaboration and bringing information together. And then another two coming in June. A couple of bonus things for you, a new icon for Dynamics 365. What do we think? And also, Microsoft has today released an implementation success by design guide. It's a free link. You can download that. It's about 700 pages of value right there. All the things you might need to know about considering strategy, implementation, preparation, operation of a Dynamics 365 deployment. So download that and check it out. Hope that's been helpful. Thanks for watching.